Welcome back. When it comes to squash, international big names, okay, Nick Matthew, Gregor Gauthier. When it comes to the top 10, you would find at least 3 to 4 Egyptians. Whenever we're talking even about men or women, doesn't make a difference. Should I mention some names? Okay, Amr Shabana, Karim Darwish, Rami Ashour, Hamad Shorbagi, Hamad Abbas, and Marwan Shorbagi also. Hatem Wael Hindi. I'm going to forget names. And when it comes to females, you would find the beauties we have. Umnaya Abdelawi, Ranim Al-Walili. And we do have now Salma, Mariam, a lot of names. I'm not going to list them all, because sure, I'm going to forget some. And in fact, I do respect and chapeau to all of them, because all those names did a lot to draw such a smile on the faces of all Egyptians because of the victories they have inside and outside Egypt. We do have men behind the camera, and we do have the one on top of the Egyptian Federation of Squash. I spoke that much because he just wanted to take a deep breath. He came that fast, and we were expecting him earlier than that. So before going into this, I would take a promise, sir, that you are going to be with us once again in another episode of Score Sheet. Amen to that?
I'd love to come many times, Antonia.
We are very much delighted to have with us Mr. Assem Khalefa, the president of the Egyptian Squash Federation. Sir, thank you very much for being with us.
Thank you for inviting me.
Should I congratulate you first about the latest victories, or should I say thank you very much for all what you're doing for this Egyptian Federation? Or should I ask about what's going on tomorrow, because you're all the time ambitious and you're all the time planning for more? Let's say first what happened with our beauties in Edenhoven and what they have done against the Americans, and when they return back, what they are planning for.
First of all, I would say that this tournament, the World Junior, which was in Eindhoven in Holland, mm-hmm. it's supposed to be in Egypt. Mm-hmm. And they cancel it and transfer it to Eindhoven due to some, we respect that they don't want to come to our country while there is some accidents eventually in mm-hmm. the region. Mm-hmm. So we were upset mm-hmm. a little bit, but we continue our camp and our training for the boys and girls, and then we travel to Eindhoven, and we do very furious because of this reason. That's why the boys and girls, they played very aggressively and very mm-hmm. strongly, powerfully mm-hmm. to get the titles. Mm-hmm. So it was two junior world junior mm-hmm. for men individual mm-hmm. and for women individual and team event.
Yeah.
Actually, we went and we believed that our boys already struggled a lot and prepared themselves a lot. But end of the day, there was a very smart boy from Piro. Mm-hmm. He's talented mm-hmm. and he's very tall and he's very experienced. And Piro is very high from the sea level, mm-hmm. so he can run something like 3 days continuous. So we went with him to the final,
yeah,
by one of our promising boys, Yusuf mm-hmm. Muhammad. Mm-hmm. And Yusuf is a talented as well, but he gave him.
But his lungs are not that big.
No, not that big, but he gave him hard time.
Yeah.
And the boy, when he finished, he said mm. that this was one of the very, very difficult matches
he had
during the last 2 years.
Wow.
So we went to the final, and we have number 2 in the boys, mm-hmm. under 19. Mm-hmm. And you know, the very lucky event or the very, you know, which I like very much are my girls, my golden girls.
Yeah.
They had number one and two and three and four.
What?
In the
Again?
Individual. In the individual.
Number one, two, three, and four.
Yes, the individual.
Yeah.
They had the title, the second.
Can we say their names?
Four. Of course.
Mariam?
No, Nooran Gohar.
Nooran Gohar.
Habiba.
Habiba Muhammad.
Habiba Muhammad, yeah. Which they played the final together.
Yeah.
And Salma Hani. And Mariam Mustafa.
And Mariam Mitwell.
Yes.
Yeah.
So luckily they didn't meet with each other in the first beginning. Otherwise we would have lost some of them.
Mm-hmm.
But each of them, you know, run into the final. Mm-hmm. So they played together in the semifinal and final.
Yeah.
So that's why we.
Then the golden score was Egyptian in general.
Yes, yes,
yeah.
Yes.
So you felt great.
I've yeah. been asked by the minister, Khaled Abdelaziz.
I think he received them. He received them and he honored them.
No, not yet. We will.
He will.
He met them before traveling.
Yeah.
In Shabab al Jazeera.
Mm-hmm.
While they have their last training before mm-hmm. traveling.
This is, I think this was in Alexandria. This is Alexandria Open.
I guess so.
Yeah, this was Alexandria Open, yeah.
I guess mm-hmm. so, I guess.
Mm-hmm. I'm sorry for the interruption,
yes.
sir.
Yes, no, at all. Engineer Khaled Abdelaziz, the minister. Oh, yes.
Yeah, Ranim.
Yes, yeah. Mm. He met them at...
I myself, when Ranim did it in...
This is Alexandria Open.
Alexandria Open. Oh. But when Ranim did it and when she had victory over Nicole David, for me, yeah. it was amazing.
This was terrific.
And
match.
It was a terrific yes. game. And whenever yes, it yes. comes to Nicole David, meaning number one for years now,
yes.
on top
for 8 years,
for 8 years on top of she's the queen.
Yes,
and let's
yes.
say so, and she deserved that. But when it comes to Ranim is much younger and
you know, the experience and, you know, there is something I told Yusuf, who was playing with...
the Peru guy.
One, you have to believe yourself that you can win.
Mm-hmm.
So this statement, mm-hmm. It should be for all the players, mm-hmm. which they used to play with a legend.
Mm-hmm.
Whenever you play with a legend, mm-hmm. you should believe yourself that you can win.
Mm-hmm.
And it's difficult, but it's not impossible.
Yeah.
So if you believe in this, this is what we were trying to do with Yusuf.
Mm-hmm.
Believe my son.
How old is he?
No, Yusuf is 18.
Mm-hmm.
18 and
okay, he has
and
such ball. A future, inshallah.
Yes, but you know, he will not catch the next junior open.
Okay.
That's why he supposed to win, mm-hmm. or he wanted to win to carry the title.
Mm-hmm.
But he, of course, he have a very bright future.
Inshallah,
yani, Rabbana bless him to. Not to suffer from injuries because squash became a very tough game.
Yeah.
But I believe that he's one of the talented players which we have. Back to Ranim,
mm-hmm.
if she believes every time that she will win, she will win.
Yeah.
You know, the only time she believed she will win was in Alexandria.
Mm-hmm.
She played in Wadi Degla, the world champion, something like 3 months before or 4 months before, mm-hmm. and she was about to beat her. But you know,
I was there, by the way.
Yes, but you know, end of the day, she lost short head. And this is, you know, I can say that, inshallah, next year, Raneem will win all the way.
Inshallah.
Inshallah.
About the other girls we were talking
other
about.
Girls, the other girls is...
the golden girls.
The golden girls is fantastic, you know, because they, I used to ask them a very clear question. When they play together, they play very tough. When they play with other foreigners, they play very soft. You said, why you play this together? Together they play a very tough game. And when they play with Americans or British or you said, because they cannot afford to play more than this. We play just to win. We're just playing just to win.
Because the Americans or the American team, those representing the American team were half Egyptian, half Americans too.
Oh yes, but they are not, they are still not up to the standard with our girls. You know, our girls, when they play together, they hit the ball like the boys, like men. They play a very professional game and very tough game.
As far as I know that you all the time have a very busy schedule.
Yes.
And all the time there is a coming championship or a coming event which is going to take place, and they're all outside Egypt. Let me ask about the new championships or the new tournaments that our players are going to be involved in.
We have a very important first time tournament. Will be held on the 26th. It will be in Shabab al-Kisira.
Here?
Yes.
Okay.
This what we can call it, the Arab International tournament. It's new. We have the agreement of the WSF to have this tournament in Egypt. This tournament is one of the out of five which define and rank the juniors in the world. It's one like the US Open and British Open and the Dutch Open.
And how many Arab countries are going to come?
We have something up till this moment, we have something like almost.
No, how many countries?
Countries, yeah. countries, something like between 8 and 10.
Okay, all Arabs?
No, there's Swiss and there's people from Africa.
Okay, but I was just thinking about the Arabs, because as you know,
the name of the tournament. No, it's just the name,
but it's an international one.
International Open. But because this is the first time, and this is, it came after the world champion in Eindhoven, so most of them started their holidays, so it was, you know, difficult for them to come back to Cairo, although they like a lot, because it is a very important practice for them.
Yeah.
But I guess that next year will be much more powerful and much more participants will be
okay, this is for the juniors. What about the seniors?
The senior will start their season starting from September. So they have first they have some tournaments in the States, and then you have the world champion in Seattle, and then we have the team event in Kuwait.
In Kuwait. Amir Shabana did it, and Amir Shabana introduced squash to the Kuwaitis, I think.
No, Kuwait. Kuwait is one of the very, very old countries.
Amir Wagi, I'm sorry. Amir Wagi.
Oh, yes.
I'm sorry.
Amir.
Amir Wagi is such an Egyptian coach who was there in Kuwait for such a long time, and he made a generation of squash players from the Kuwaiti people, and they are now enjoying such a standard.
Yes. So Kuwait have two, three generations, one of the best, and they are doing a big effort to generate and create, you know, several players, starting from juniors, and they have a very talented player, Abdallah Al-Misayin, and they are camping here, by the way.
Great. They are most welcome, of course.
Yes, because I am the president of the Arab Federation, so they used to come here too, because I was trying all the time to arrange for them the camps and the clubs, players to play. So they like to come to Egypt. You know, Egypt became the
hub of
the destination,
squash.
The destination, yeah. the hub of squash. So yeah. Everybody wants to see the Egyptian squash. Everybody wants to play with Egyptian players. Everybody wants to come to see Egyptians.
There in Wadi Degla, Karim Darwish is doing great with the new generations of squash
Karim,
players.
Karim have done a very good tournament. Yeah.
Sir, we have a promise to have you again, because I'd like to ask about the Olympic Games and what we are going to do to try to introduce squash again into the Olympic Games. We want to make sure that everything is okay with our players, with injuries and media reports saying who is going to participate in what. So promise?
All I have to say, I'm very sorry for coming late, and I beg you to invite me again.
Oh, you are most welcome,
my
sir.
Pleasure. It's my pleasure to come and speak about squash. You know, I appreciate very much your
We are following them, sir, all the time, and we will continue on that.
You are doing a very good job for squash, I guess.
Thank you, sir. Mr. Assem Khalefa, the president of the Egyptian Federation of Squash. Thank you very much, sir.
Thanks a lot.
We are running out of time. On behalf of our director, Dr. Mohammed Rabi, Amr Fathallah, the staff of Studio 35, myself, Nermina Abdurrahman, many thanks for watching. Wait for us, same time on Nile TV International, another episode of Score Sheet. And as usual, Assalamu alaikum.